for a new edition of campus. Set for a new edition of my campus life video blog. Every time I went to UNO, and something strikes me, because I heard this on the news yesterday, that, you guessed it, Joe Biden's coming to UNO. No way. And this is gonna be ridiculous. But what about Kamala Harris? As far as we're concerned, coming to Omaha? You wish. This doesn't even make sense. Anyways, here's my observation for you. If you know what I'm saying. About the college students wants to blame Trump for the... it's what? Here's my purpose. College kids. Those no good for nothing college kids. Blame Trump for the shutdown, and give me one good reason why, but they're changing their tunes after learning the crucial facts. Ain't that a trip? Ain't that a trip? And give me one good reason why, because while the partial government shutdown was in effect, oh boy. Cabot Phillips visit George Mason University in North Virginia to get impressions from the students, and it was surprisingly not, because most of the students who took their part inside the video try to blame Trump for the shutdown, which that was the longest run in American history. Listen to this, you guessed it. That's right. Campus Reform to put out a video from YouTube.com. Just listen to this. This is so ridiculous about this.
What's your thought on who's to blame for the shutdown?
The president.
I think specifically Trump. Since this has been the longest government shutdown, he is mainly responsible.
Personally, Trump.
I would definitely say Trump.
I would say mostly on Trump.
Maybe get the government working again, like that would be good.
Okay.
Trump is probably to blame.
If President Trump were to make some of the concessions that Democrats have been asking for, like protection for DACA Dreamers, $800 million for humanitarian aid, extra funding for judges to get some of the immigration cases moving, if you were to offer those three things, do you think the Democrats should consider compromising on their end?
Yes, they should. Yeah, I would agree. I think that they should compromise.
I think that would be a good start.
They should allow some funding for the wall for now if Trump were to agree to some of their terms as well.
Getting the government working and getting those protections for, like, Dreamers, that's obviously super important. And if, like, conceding, like, a small portion of that, of something that's probably not going to be done, it's, like, kind of a bittersweet kind of...
Did you know President Trump actually has offered that already?
Really?
No, I didn't know. Yeah.
Are you surprised by that?
Yeah, like... Yeah.
And what are your thoughts on that?
I don't know.
So, are you...
You don't even know it, haven't you? You try to change your tune, huh? Because Cabot Phillips has a bigger twist than this. Because likely you try to bank on those students. Yeah, that's right, college students. Of not knowing that Trump has already... offered those no good for nothing wascally Looney Tune Democratic buffoon Smurfs has a deal to end this shutdown, and which includes extend protections such as the deferred action for childhood arrivals. And do you know how much it costs, as far as we're concerned? $800 million. In a humanitarian aid, and more border agents and immigration and judges just like this about this whole scenario. And that's why Cabot Phillips, yes, nails it down with this whole scenario. Asking those college students at George Mason University, University in Virginia, and I have no objection whatsoever, don't we all learn this at all? It makes a lot of, it makes no reasons about this one. But there is more about this one, about this you-know-who, compromising there, yeah, on their end. If Trump were making this, making the latter concessions, well, they have to respond, says yes. Oh, Lord have mercy. But there's more about this one. Listen to this.
Are you surprised by him offering those compromises?
I would say, yeah. I would say it is pretty surprising. Okay, that's awesome, then. You know, I'm obviously behind him.
What do you mean that's awesome? What do you mean that's awesome?
I'm pleasantly surprised that he's offered those things, for sure.
And do you think the Democrats should have taken the compromise President Trump offered?
I do think so. The compromise isn't worth it to them, I guess.
Would you say Pelosi should consider compromising on that, or hold the line? What do you think?
I think anything that gets things going again. Yeah.
It was the wrong move for her to turn it down.
What would be your message to Nancy Pelosi in response to shooting down that offer?
Compromise, compromise, compromise.
Compromise, 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 you know, compromise this, compromise this, compromise that.
Basically all of it, not much.
I'm learning a lot. That's what I can say for sure.
Okay.
You see, you don't know. Because here's my observation for you. Kappa Phillips has their information students that have then informed those college students that Trump didn't make that very offer to those very concessions, and everybody knows that. Would you know that Democratic idiot bimbo, you guessed it, Nancy Stretch Pelosi, has been rejected about this one, could be civilized according to CBSNews.com, because he has made a huge announcement about this one. Well, guess what? I have no objection whatsoever. And I have no objection. And this is why. And you know why? Because it pays to be nice to people. You have no idea, do you? But you know, I hate to break this to you, but the moral of this, you know who, my campus life video blog story, is this. It's just upon this whole learning that the crucial fact that the surprised college students at George Mason University has been singing inside this different tune, and everybody has to agree with this, agreed with Democratic buffoon Smurfs, should come to an end, to come to this, the negotiated table. I don't know, because this is ridiculous. And rather with Trump, this as letting down the shutdown has to continue. But guess what? It was the wrong move for Nancy Pelosi, that's right, to step down. Thank you, Kevin Phillips, for interviewing those students. That's my Campus Life video blog story. I'm sticking to it. We're right back with OSC and hashtag Omo Choirs. Only on Facebook after this. Stay with us.